What I teach the young people is that libation is poured to honor our ancestors, okay? And so we're gonna pour the libation, which will be water, into a container that has earth, because that is from what we come and where we're gonna go. Okay, back to the earth. And so we're gonna pay homage to that. And so the first thing we do is we pour a little libation to God by all of the names that he is known and that people call him. This is what I teach the children. So some people call God Allah, some people call God God, some people call God Yahweh, but God is God, okay? and a higher power that we all look towards, you know. Well, let me say that some of us look towards, okay? Because we know we can't do it all by ourselves, okay?
Right.
And it's good to have a little something else to hold on to, you know, to know that, look, this is not, I don't have to handle this all by myself. Okay. Then we call on
him.
That's right. Yeah. And so, and then, you know, there are some lesser gods, you know, there is Narcole, a female god, yes, goddess, and then we call upon those who have gone before us, and those who are in our families who have gone before us, those who have meant much to us, you know, like, there's Miss Susie B. Scott. She was my mama's best friend. She was a snuff dipper. And every Sunday morning when she felt like testifying, she did. And so I pour libation to Miss Susie B. Scott. And maybe you have somebody that you want libation to pour to. If you do, call out the name. After the name is called out, we say our shape. Okay? Anybody got a name?
Rachel Green.
All right, Ashe.
Michelle Davis,
Ashe. And Martin Luther King, I heard. Ashe. Anyone else?
Shelly McCoy.
Okay. Ashe.
Harriet Tubman.
Ashe.
Angela.
Ashe.
Julia
Vaughn. Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe.
Matt Little.
Ashe. All right. And so then we ended by saying, are we not all saying this in one voice? And we say, Ashe. Now, this is what gets the people a little bit, but I'm going to tell you, there is science to go with it. Are we not all one people?
Yes.
Ashe. And let me just give you a little bit about that, because the oldest bones, where were they found? So we all cousins. Yes, we are. We are all related. We all belong to this one human race. There's not a whole bunch of other things going on, but you got to see my mood about that. He talks about it. But you know, there's one human race. We got a bunch of nationalities and cultures and ethnicities, but we are all one human race. Ashe.
Ashe.
All right, and that's it. Thank you. So, I'm a storyteller, and on this occasion, as storytellers, you know, we should take the responsibility of making sure that folks know our history. So, I was thinking about one of the principles, and so I thought that I would teach from that point of view the principle, the last principle called Imani, and Imani means faith. And one of our ancestors that I think worked on faith most for me, in a way, is Harriet Tubman. Because Harriet Tubman couldn't read or write. And Harriet, you know, had been knocked upside the head with a stone thing. And so she would have, you know, she would go to sleep every now and then. But the other thing is that Harriet decided that she wasn't supposed to be somebody's slave. Now, the first time she decided to run, she was going to run with her brother. But gonna go back. But the next time, she left by herself. And she only had to deal with her fear. But she had faith that this freedom, this Northland, had to be better than anything that she was in. And so she made her way north. But she wasn't satisfied when she got north. You know, all of her family still left down in this system of nastiness and evilness called slavery. And so she went back. Now when she would go back, of course she didn't show herself, but she'd hide out in the woods a little bit, near the fields, and she might sing, steal away, steal away, steal away to Jesus. And that would mean, look, tonight I'm gonna be taking a train to freedom. It's on the Underground Railroad. And if you want to join me, come on. But the thing is, if you join her, or as they used to say in Southern Africanism, if they jined her, well, they had to keep on going, okay? Because she knew that if they turned around and they were caught, that they would give up the routes and the safe houses. Because the Quakers were very important with those safe houses, you know. They had to hide folks out in the barns, in the houses, on the floorboards, and all kinds of things. And so Harriet said, we can't get those up. Those are very important. And so, you know, she would go back. Now the thing is, you think about this woman who couldn't read, couldn't write. But what they said about her was this, that if she needed to make a decision, if she was in a quandary, she would pray. And unlike most of us, she would wait for the answer. You know, most of us, we pray, but we take it up on our own anyhow. Because he just not answering fast enough. He's not doing nothing about it fast enough. But she would wait, so she never lost a passenger. She never got caught. And so she was able to bring over 300 people out of that system of nastiness, of evilness called slavery. And but she wasn't done yet when that Civil War came. Cause you know, sometimes folks just don't notice you. And that's what most folks want. Most folks want to be acknowledged as a human being. You know, if you pass somebody on the street, try this, okay? Say, how you doing? Keep on going, but say, how you doing? That's acknowledging people. And so because she wasn't acknowledged and knew she was gonna be ignored, especially if she just looked like a regular person, she put on a little bonnet and stuff, and she would be running around in the towns finding out what was going on and taking it back to the Union soldiers, yeah? And so that way she was able to give information. She was a spy during the Civil War and a nurse, you know? But she lived out her life knowing about roots, because you know when you in the woods with babies, the babies get tired and the babies want to cry and fuss. But she could have them doing that. She needed them to be quiet, so she knew what the teas were to give them so that they would sleep when they needed to sleep. So Harriet worked on faith. And I would like to say that with everything that's going on, we need to work on some faith too. We need to try to make sure that we're doing all we can to make things equal and righteous for everybody. And that's Harriet's story to you all.